Hi everyone, today we're creating a beautiful lake environment in Unreal Engine. Watch till the end to see how it's done. Let's get started.
So first we are gonna create a new project. I'm gonna go with blank template without any starter content. And I'm gonna name it tutorial. And create a new project. After creating the project, go to file, new level and create a basic level. Now I'm gonna delete this default ground. Now we need to create a new landscape. Before creating landscape, I'm gonna download the height map for the landscape. As you can see, you can download high quality height map from this website for free. For this tutorial, I'm gonna use this Great Lakes height map. Just click on download here. And download it anyway. After downloading the height map, extract here. As you can see that the height map that we have is an EXR file format. First we need to convert it to PNG file format. You can easily convert it in Photoshop, but if you don't have Photoshop, simply open your browser and search EXR to PNG converter. For example, I'm using this convert.io. Just select EXR to PNG and choose the file that we want to convert. I'm gonna select this height map and click on convert. Once it completed, just click on download. Now as you can see, we have this height map in the PNG file format. Now in Unreal Engine, we just need to go to landscape. From here, landscape, and here we just need to click on this import from file. Now in the height map file, we are going to select our height map like that and click on open. Now you can see that our height map. If you want to adjust something, you can also adjust it. Like I'm going to adjust the scale like that, something like 128. We don't need to change anything here. Just make sure to enable edit layers and click on import. Here you can see that our landscape is completely disappeared. That's because of this exponential height fog. Just select the exponential height fog and drag it up like that. Now we are going to apply a material to our landscape. So I have already downloaded my landscape material, which is wild grass. So I'm just going to click on export here. Just select the landscape and navigate to the material. Here, just select the material instance like that. And by selecting the landscape, go to landscape material. Right here, just click on this arrow. Now to fix the tiling of this material, just double click on material instance. Now here you can see that the tiling and offset. Just enable it and expand this tab like that. And just decrease the tiling like 0.01. Now it looks better than before. Now we can add water to our landscape. So first we need to enable our water plugin. Just go to edit, plugins, and here you can search water. Just enable the first plugin like that and restart your engine. Also make sure to save everything. After restarting, here in the plus icon you can search water. Now you can see all the water classes right here. We just need to drag and drop this water body lake like that. Now before expanding the water, we just need to untick this effect landscape. Now we can expand our water by dragging those points. You can also add a spline point by right clicking here and add spline point here. Now we are going to add trees to our landscape. Now for the trees, I'm using this landscape asset from Epic Game. It's completely free. You can also download that and add it to your project. I'm just going to go to add to project and select our project and add it like that. Now as you can see, we have this STF folder. If you don't see these filters here, you can also enable it from here. I'm just going to select the static mesh filter And here you can see we have all the static mesh right here. I'm just going to use these pine trees. So first I'm going to go in foliage mode. Here we just need to drag and drop these trees like that. So first select all of these trees. And decrease the density to 0.01 like that. And in the scale, increase the scale like 4 to 5. Now we don't need to change anything here. I'm just going to increase the brush size from here like that. And start painting those trees to our landscape. Now to avoid this portrait, we just need to sculpt our landscape. First go to landscape mode and select the sculpt tool and just sculpt right here. I'm just going to increase the density a little bit, like 0.01. Now after painting the trees, I'm going to add this rocky ground and also some other rock assets to my project. You can download all of these assets from QuixelBridge for free. After importing those to our project, just go to content browser, click on mega scan and click on this static mesh filter like that. And here you can see all the assets. Just drag and drop this rock asset right here. I have customized the color of the water a little bit. You can also do that. Just select the water and navigate to the water material. Right here you can see that. Double click to open it. After opening it, scroll down a little bit. Now here you can see that the color of the water is almost the same as default. I'm just adding the scattering color like dark blue. You can also add dark blue like that. Just enable the scattering. You can see the difference here. After changing it, just close the tab like that. After that, I'm gonna add the foliage. For the foliage, I'm just using this ribbon grass right here. You can see that. You can also download the same if you want. After importing it, go to foliage mode from here. Now you can see that the foliage has automatically detected these grass assets. Here. If you don't see those grass assets here, then you just need to select all of these assets and drag and drop in foliage mode like that. After that, I'm gonna deselect all of these trees like that and enable those grass assets. I'm just going to increase the scale a little bit. Now for me, 3 is the perfect one. You can also change it if you want. Now I'm just gonna paint the foliage according to my camera angle. Now after painting the foliage, let's just change the lighting little bit. Now in the selection mode, hold Ctrl L and drag the mouse like that. Now you can see that the exposure is too much, so we need to change it. For that, go to plus icon and add post process volume. Just drag and drop the post process volume here. And by selecting it, in the details panel of this post process volume, search infinite. And enable this infinite extend unbound. After that, here in the exposure section, enable this metering mode and exposure composition. And change the auto exposure to manual like that. and change the intensity to something like 8. Now select the directional light and increase the intensity like that to something like 60 or 58. And in the image effects, enable the vignette and sharpen. Increase the intensity little bit like that. And also increase the vignette intensity. After that, in the color grading section, in global, enable the saturation box like that. And change the saturation to something like 1.5. And also change the mid-tone saturation to 1.2. Now we are done with this post process. Now we're gonna add some background mountains to add extra depth. Now for the background mountains, I'm using this background asset from Epic Game. It's completely free. While adding this asset to your project, you might encounter this problem. It says that this asset is not compatible with the 5.3 version. We just need to change the 5.3 to 5.0 early access. Now in the content browser, you can see that the photoreal background is right here. Just click on static mesh filter like that. And if you want to increase the thumbnail size, you can also increase it. Just click on the settings. Here in thumbnail size, change it from medium to large. Now I'm using these green mountains, as you can see, just drag and drop them into your scene. Now we are also gonna paint the trees to our background mountains. Now for the trees in the photoreal background, you can see that 2D billboard right here. I'm gonna use this 2D billboard. Just go to foliage mode and drag and drop this 2D tree billboard like that. The density is too much, so I'm going to decrease it. Now we're gonna add some fog. For that, just click on exponential height fog and bring it right here. Now by selecting the exponential height fog, you can also change the color of it if you want. I'm gonna change it to like something blue. You can also increase or decrease the fog density. If you want to animate the grass, you can animate it. Just navigate to the grass folder and open the grass material instance. And here search grass wind. Just enable the grass wind like that and also tick this box. And hit save. As you can see, the grass is animated. Now we're gonna add level sequencer to our scene. To add level sequencer, click right here and add level sequencer and also save the level sequencer like that. And we are also gonna add camera to our scene. So just click on this plus icon right here and search camera. And drag and drop this cine camera actor like that. In the outliner, right click on camera and snap object to view. Just switch to the camera mode from here, and in the details panel of the camera, we need to change some settings. Change the film back from digital film to DSLR, and also we need to decrease the focal length to something like 15, and also increase the current aperture to something like 4. You can also change the light direction if you want. After that, just drag and drop the cine camera actor to our sequencer like that. And you can also change the frame rate if you want. I'm also gonna increase the timeline length like that. And also increase the camera cuts. Now we are gonna animate the camera. Just add the transform keyframe at the starting of the timeline and navigate to the end of the timeline right here and just change the location of the camera something like that. And add a transform keyframe right here. Now select both of these keyframes and right click. Change the interpolation mode to linear. As you can see, the camera is animated. now we are going to render this shot through Movie Render Queue. First, we need to enable the Movie Render Queue plugin. For that, go to Edit, Plugins, search Movie Render Queue, and enable the Movie Render Queue plugin like that, and restart your engine. Make sure to save everything. After restarting the engine, just click on this render icon right here and click on unsaved config settings right here. Now for the rendering, I'm using some basic settings which works really well. First, I'm gonna delete this JPEG sequence and I'm gonna add the PNG sequence. If you want to use the EXR, you can also use it, but I'm gonna go with PNG sequence. And also add anti-aliasing and change the temporal sample count to something like 32. And make sure to enable this override anti-aliasing. And in advanced, change the warm-up counts to 120. Now in the output tab, you can change the output directly like that. And you can also change the resolution and frame rate if you want. After that, just click on accept and render local.
If you found this tutorial helpful, please subscribe to my channel. It motivates me to keep creating awesome tutorials for you. Thanks for watching.